I am Professor Darshan Amore, KKVA College of Horticulture, Nasik. Today I am going to see about biological method of weed control. In biological method, use of living organism like insect, disease organism, herbivore, fish, snail, or even competitive plants for the control of weeds is called as biological control. In biological control method, it is not possible to eradicate weed, but weed population can be reduced. This method is not useful to control all types of weed. Introduced weeds are best target for biological control. Some of the qualities of bioagents. The bioagent must be feed on affect only one host and not other useful plant. Then it must be free of predator or parasite. It must readily adapt to environmental conditions. And the bioagent must be capable of seeking out itself to the host. It must be able to kill the weed or at least prevent its reproduction in some direct or indirect way. It must possess reproductive capacity sufficient to overtake the increase of its host species without too much delay. So this is the bioagent qualities of bioagent. It must have a high reproductive capacity that can be spread over the field fastly and control weed population. Then merits of biological method. It is least harm to the environment and it's having no residual effect. Relatively cheaper and comparatively long lasting effect will not affect on non-targeted plant and safer in use. Then demerits. The multiplication is costlier. It's required specific lab for its multiplication. Then control is very slow. The success of control is very limited and it's require long time to control of weed. Very few host specific bioagents are available at present. The mode of action of bioagent. Differential growth habits, competitive ability of a crop and varieties prevent weed establishment, for example groundnut, cowpea, fast growing and so good weed suppressor. Then next one is insect kill the plants by exhausting plant food reserves, defoliation, boring and weakening the structure of plants. Then pathogenic organism damage the host plant through enzymatic degradation of cell constituents, production of toxins, disturbance of hormone system, then obstruction in the translocation of food materials and minerals, and malfunctioning of physiological process. So the pathogenic organism damage the host plant through the enzymatic degradation of cell constituent and non-effect on specific crop or the agricultural crops. It is a effect on only targeted plants. Then the mode of action is production of toxins and disturbance the hormonal system of host plant. Then obstruction in the translocation of food materials, minerals and malfunctioning of physiological process. Some of the outstanding examples of biological weed control. First is larvae of Coctoblastis cactorum, a moth borer, control prickly pear, Optunia species. The larvae tunnel through the plants and destroyed it. In India, it is controlled by cochineal insect or Dactylopius indicus, etc. and also the Dactylopis domentosus. Next one, Lantana camara. It is controlled by larvae of Crocidosema lantana, a moth borer into the flower stem, eat flowers and fruits. Then Cuscuta species, it is controlled by Melangromyza cuscuti and Cyprus rotundus. The bioagent is Bactra burutana, a moth borer. Then Ludwigia parviflora, it is completely denuded by Ultica cyanea, steel blue beetle. Then herbivorous fish, tilapia, control algae, common crop, crab, or non-herbivorous fish control submerged aquatic weeds. It is apparently due to the uprooting of plants while in search of food. Snail prefers submerged weeds. Then bioherbicides or mycoherbicides. The use of plant pathogen which is expected to kill the targeted weeds. These are native pathogen cultured artificially and spread just like post-emergence herbicide each season on targeted weeds, particularly in crop areas. In bioherbicide, the fungal pathogen of weed have been used to larger extent than bacterial, viral, nematode pathogens because bacteria and virus are unable to actively penetrate the host and require natural opening or vectors to initiate disease in a plant. Here the specific fungal spore or their fermentation product is spread against the target weed. Some registered mycoherbicides in Western countries are tabulated below. So the first mycoherbicide is Divine. The content of Divine is a liquid suspension of fungal spores of Phytophthora palmivora. It causes a root rot disease. Then it is the targeted weed of Divine is Stranglevine Morinia odorata in citrus. Then second one is the Colago, vetebal powder containing fungal spores of Colletotrichum gloeosporidus, causal organism, and causes a stem and leaf blight. The targeted weed is joint wedge in rice and soybean. Then Biopolaris, a suspension of fungal spores of Biopolaris sorgicola. Targeted weed is Johnson grass, sorghum halfens. Then Biolophos, the content of Biolophos, a microbial toxin produced as a fermentation product of Streptomyces hygroscopicus. Targeted weed, non-specific and general vegetation. It is recommended for general vegetation. Then, the limitation of biological weed control. After feeding on the host plant, this insect may move to economical plants. So, there is a more risk of damage to economical plant. Rearing of insect is a big problem for rearing insect on a large scale in the laboratory. Lots of space as well as different types of substrate is required. Biological control is a very costly method of weed control because screening of insect is done in laboratory. Most of the insect do not adjust to the environmental condition. So, lots of investment required for screening of desirable predators. Then, isolation of desired area from which one wants to keep off the insect is not possible as there is no available method with which a target can be achieved. So, this is all about biological method of weed control. Thank you.